So it's honored to have this prestige award. Jeffrey Bawa Award is like one of the best award in Sri Lanka. To get that award is like among the top best of the best architecture work, and it has recognized the actually tropical architecture who have done in locally, done by the Sri Lankan architect as well as the foreign architects. Those are among the shortlisted projects. So we were actually with a small project, but I think they, you know, in respectively the scale, it doesn't matter. So it may be the architecture has recognized. So I think it's a really honor to receive this award. Yeah, this project is the Frame Imadua. It's actually experimental project. So I think it is designed for a jazz ethnomusician. So I think it has addressed to different issues at the site. So the site was very beautiful and 5-acre abandoned grass field. And that property was belongs to them, ancestral property, and it's coming from their generation, but it has not used for any purpose rather than having these agricultural purpose. But due to these floods, so it was abandoned and it is only grass field. So that my client and my friend actually, he came to me and asked about, can we do some project and he would like to, you know, connect to the village back again to the roots and want to do something like a getaway home, like a weekend home for the family. And then again, I said, okay, yeah, because this is my second project with him. I have done his home before and known to me, and then we made the visit. So it was so beautiful. It's almost like a horizontal plane, and it's wonderful. And again, I thought of, I may not able to design anything there because it's very serene and very quiet. And then I thought of, I wanted to make a building that has to be disappeared with the context. And then again, the client budget, and there were some restraint like budget, time, and there are so much like, and again, we may not able to do a foundation in that kind of grass. And again, it was not solid ground. So we were just trying to find a solution to come up with the different answers. That building has to be lift above the ground to be like 5 feet. And then it came to mind, why can't we use the scaffolding? Because the scaffolding itself has a nice module, and people are using that as a temporary building or to do construction work. So I thought it's a good typology to make it like out of scaffolding. So we studied that proportion of the scaffolding, and we're trying to work with the scaffolding as a module. And we played that in a different height, and then the length of it, and we got that standard of the building, all the proportion out of the scaffolding dimensions. So then we thought of, we have to make it like building can be dismantled anytime. So it may be the good solution in a flood plane kind of thing, so that you fix it, and if you are, like, if you want to change it or relocate it, you can do it. So it's not heavily anchored to the ground. And it is actually itself has a 5 feet height, so then we can easily get over that flood level. So then we were trying to use the scaffolding, and then we use a lot of material that we can recycle, and especially that platforms we use for walkways and steel checker plates for the decks, and some of the, even the furniture, we're trying to work with this kind of recycled materials. So I think plans influence was involvement is very much, I had to recognize his involvement as a part of the project success. Yes, the Reba International Award is like excellence for architecture. 2021 is one of the best award that I think of have getting it internationally, because it's recognized the best project in the world among the any practice. So our practice is very small, and in Sri Lanka, so I think recognize our practice, and this project is a huge mark, you know, putting our Sri Lanka on the map, world map, is like something really wonderful and honor. I think they have recognized this building irrespectively the scale or any other, you know, because it's a very small house. It's for an artist retreat, and the budget is very small compared to the other project in the list of that. Actually, this is a 16 project among the World International Project. Reeb Award received for this artist retreat at Pitugala. That this project is designed for the artist couple, J.C. Ratnayake, and actually they were part of my projects. I have used their work, and they not got to know me before this project, and they were asked whether I can help with their design. So basically, we have to work together because the budget was extremely low. Then I have to come up with different answers. But actually, it's really easy to work with people who has a understanding about the good quality architecture and the aesthetic values. So basically, it was very easy to convince and cooperate with this kind of a client. So it was a blessing. So I was actually happy to give him answers. And we want to keep the budget low by using a different options, like keeping the ground floor totally open. And we want to create like a pavilion that is like a garden pavilion that almost like connected with the garden, series of garden. And but it has a shelter. But we left the total ground floor open to reduce the budget. And then again, we left only the kept the upper floor for this private area, and we secured that section. So by doing all that thing, and we use exposed brilling, the brick, and that makes it more like a cost-effective material. And some parts we plastered, and then it makes it more like a comfortable area, and give a little bit of a different contrast to these unplaster and the plaster. So it's actually another project that I really enjoy. We won 2019 Reeb Award for the studio dwelling at Rajagiriya. So this is my residence and the office. So this was actually recognized among these 20 projects in 2019 as an international award for the excellence in architecture. So that was a really big thing, and we won consecutive years Reeb Award. That is also something big for us. So this is actually a very small project in a 10 purchase of land in near marsh. So we wanted to make the building almost like a float above the ground, because in any flood condition I want to safeguard my office. So I left the parking at the lower level and leave the ground without filling it, so water can be going through the parking area. So the first floor is the my office and studio, and the first, second and the third is my residence. In architecture, I always trying to open to ideas, and we're trying to work with the context, and we have to work with the I'm trying to absorb from the site, because things are coming naturally. Because when I'm designing, I always trying to work with the feel, and then trying to recreate that feeling and mood or something. We visualize the building and how it works with the surrounding and how it's merged with the landscape, because it's a big part of the architecture. So I think architecture always work as a whole, not like only as a building itself, like a building we are as architecture. So we have to think how it works with the user, and then how it works with the landscape and the context, and relevant to the neighborhood, and again the climate. So I think these are all the factors that we normally consider when we are designing, and again the budget, and we have to go for a design theme and concept kind of a thing. So we always will minimize the input. So we have to get only relevant selected material or a mood that when you are trying to create a design. So first of all, we think what is suits to that. So each project has a different flavor or a different mood or experience to the person. So we always believe that experience is always gives you a different answer to the architectural issues. So we always trying to get it from the site, from the client, and keep it open. And we always flexible to work with any material, could it going to be work and supports the concept. I think when you are doing experimental architecture or a new things, you're always taking a risk, because it may be not have done before, because we always not trying to do the answer that is suitable for another project, because each project has a different condition, and we have to address to that. So we come up with a different, always trying to be different challenges with the different experience. And again, experimental architecture always a challenge, but it gives you a satisfaction, and end of the day it recognizes that sometimes it may be a mistake, but it won't be like a always you have to take it, because I think to do good architecture you have to do some sort of a new thing. Novel thing always gives you recognition. And again, I feel as a architect I always want to find a solution for the different each problem. These two awards actually giving us the confidence to do more good work, and the recognition is really important for a practice like this. And we are doing this practice for now 16 years, but I believe it's almost like a young practice still, because I'm still learning and want to do good architecture, want to do experimental architecture, to do something for the architecture in Sri Lanka. So I think we always do the next project as a challenge, and again we develop our career as a thinking pattern, and we always want to move forward with the next project. So it's actually a good start, and having this award and this getting locally and international recognition, and I think it's good for the as a firm, as a country, to continue.